Kasama namin ngayon ang kalbong mahilig magpatawa, Jokoy! Hi, Jokoy!
What a nice introduction.
Nice to have you on the domination.
It's bad enough I'm insecure, and then she goes, hey, look, we got a bald guy. He has no more hair.
Yeah, but wait, do you shampoo your hair?
I still shampoo.
Whatever's left of
it. That's what sucks. When you're bald, you still go through the routines of acting like you have hair. So I do the shampoo, I massage the head, and then I wash it off. Uh-huh. And then for some crazy reason, I grab conditioner. And then I do the conditioner on the hair too.
And then you wrap it in a towel.
Yeah, then I wrap it in.
That's and then you comb.
And then yeah, and then I comb. And I don't leave the house because my hair isn't right. Having a bad hair day.
So Jokoy, why Jokoy?
Why Jokoy?
Yes, what's your real name?
Real name, okay, it's a white name. It's the whitest name you could possibly think of.
What is it?
Joseph Glenn Herbert.
That's Filipino. Oh.
That is as white as it gets. Uh-huh. But Jokoy, the reason why Jokoy is because when I was growing up, my aunt used to call me Jokoy. That was my nickname. She gave, you know, I think everyone has that aunt that names everybody.
Something else.
Something. Yeah. So, like, my Ati Lin was Lengoy. And then, I'm not joking. And then my Ati Belle, Annabelle, she used to call her Bang Bang, Tita Bang. So we called her Tita Bang. And then Mona, which is my cousin, Mona Gay. And sometimes we should just drop Mona and just call her Gay. Gay! Alicadito! And then of course, me, I was Jokoy.
Did you like it?
Oh, it was my name. I just grew up being called Jokoy. And when I started stand-up, it was so hard to do Joseph Herbert. Like, it was hard to go on stage because everyone was laughing at my name already. And I was trying to think of a name that I could use where I wouldn't have to worry about following my name, you know, where people were laughing already. So I remember just sitting there with my cousin Mona, because it's her mother, my Ati Ev, that does it. And she said, Jokoy. And I go, that's the name I'll use. Mm-hmm. I'll just go by Jokoy. And it stuck with me ever since, 15 years later. So that's when it all started.
So how did you discover that you have the passion to make people laugh?
In the Philippines.
Really?
Yeah, I was like, I always wanted to be a comedian. But when I was like 6 or 7 in the Philippines, like my mom's friends would always go, oh my God, you're a comedian. You're so funny. You're going to be a famous comedian when you grow up.
What were you doing? I don't know. I just
made adults laugh. Like, I was always able to make, like, older people laugh, you know?
Right. Not,
yeah, and it just always stuck through. Like, you know, my dad was in the military, and so we always had to move to different schools. And one thing I never got worried about going to a different school because I knew I was going to be the funny guy.
Right.
Like, I always knew I was going to be the funny guy at the school. So I was very confident, and I knew I had that ability to make people laugh. Mm-hmm. And I remember when I was like in the, I think the 8th grade, I told myself I'm going to be a comedian when I get out of high school. I'm going to be a stand-up comic. And
But what about when you began dating? Because sometimes all the girls, they don't want the funny guy. They want the hunks. The handsome guy.
Did you hear that? Did you hear what she just said? She goes, the girls don't want the funny guys.
Hold on, let
me finish what you said. This is what she said. She goes, they just want the hunks.
I said sometimes.
The first priority would be the hunks, and the second would be the funny
guy. Okay, hold on. Can't I just be a hunk that's also funny?
No, but see, you're both.
I'm both. Wow, she got out of that hole quick. You are both.
Yeah. So how was it? Like,
no,
going
actually,
on dates?
To be honest, girls like it when they're around funny guys. You know what I mean? And especially when they're bald.
Okay, when you're on a date, what's your punchline? What's your ultimate punchline that always works?
When I'm with a girl?
Yeah.
I like to make sure they don't have their seatbelt on and slam on the brake and go, oi. I saved your life again.
That's so Filipino.
Yeah. And she goes like this, Abba, you're my hero. Shh. I go like that, shh.
So tapos siya yung papagbayad mo.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, my God.
After saving your life, yes, her life, you'll make her pay.
Exactly. Pay for the date, at least.
Now, what about your wife? Tell us about that.
Was She's it... beautiful.
I know she is.
She's the best, man. She gave me a beautiful boy. Mm-hmm. And here's the thing. She's half Filipino, half white like me. Mm-hmm. And so we had a baby. So I guess that makes him full Filipino, full white. Right? Uh-huh. It's got to be. Uh-huh. But what I love about, Angie, is she understands that I have to do stand-up, you know what I mean? And it's hard. Like, I'm always on the road. You know, after this, I got to get on a plane, and I'm going to London. Mm-hmm. And then when I come home, I'm only home for a day from London, and then I go to New York.
Wow.
Yeah, so it's really hard, but she understands. This is what my passion is, right. and it also pays the bills.
Does she still laugh at all your jokes?
Oh, my God. Well, she's a ham, too, herself. She's funny. She's mm-hmm. she's really funny, and I think that's why we have a good chemistry together. And my son's a clown.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Oh, he's ridiculous. He's a clown. He tells people he's funnier than me. Mm-hmm. He, you know, it's just funny.
I watch you on YouTube and on Laugh Factory in L.A.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Is it true, the Ting Ting story of your son? Is that true?
That is totally, totally true. That's one thing I love
about... Carmina doesn't know about the Ting Ting.
Yeah, you have to tell me about the Ting Ting.
All right, Ting Ting is... All right.
You
all right,
can do
let
it.
Me tell you what it is. All right, this is what it is. My son calls his teeth Ting Ting Ting. Is that bad?
No, that's it's not honest. Because it's coming from you. No, right? You're a comedian, yeah.
It's yeah, I mean, he calls it his Ting Ting.
Ting Ting without the NGNG.
Yeah,
so it's the same
yeah.
thing.
So he calls it Ting Ting, and he loves to show everybody the package. That's his way of saying hi. So, like, if you were to come over, if you came over, my son would go to his room, take off his pants, and go, look at my Ting Ting.
Serious?
Oh.
He probably learned that from you.
No!
I
he
bet.
Didn't learn that from me.
I bet he did.
He taught himself that.
Because his is called Tong Tong.
Uh-oh.
Not Ting Ting.
That is true. I do call it the Tong Tong.
Tell us about your shows coming up.
My shows. Okay, here's a cool thing. I got my half-hour special, which is on Comedy Central right mm-hmm. now. Took me 15 years to get it, so please watch that. And right now, I'm a regular on the Chelsea Lately Show,
wow.
which is
love
on
that
E.
Show.
So, oh, do you?
Yeah.
Okay, so
I love
we,
that too.
Yeah, she's a really good friend of mine. Mm-hmm. And so that August 6th, that'll be I'm on that again. And then I Love the Millennium on VH1, mm-hmm. which is a big show, and they're repeating it, and it's always on the air, so mm-hmm. make sure you watch that. Mm-hmm. But here's the best part.
What is it?
With David I had a meeting with the executives over at Comedy Central, mm-hmm. and Doug Herzog, the president, offered me my own television show.
Wow!
Yeah.
Ting Ting!
Yeah!
Time so. To whip out the...
Yeah, the Ting Ting! So yeah, it's going to be a sketch comedy show, and it's called The Joe Coy Show, mm-hmm. and it's going to come out in October. Mm-hmm. I got a great executive producer mm-hmm. that's going to actually help me make this vision possible.
Wow. And, yeah. I'm gonna watch out for
well, that. Oh, it's going to be beautiful.
As you said, it took you 15 years to 15. Get where you are, and you know that it's very organic, and
yeah.
all the Pinoys to have that Pinoy sense of humor.
Yeah.
And we know that there are a lot of our viewers or a lot of Pinoys out there who do want to follow in your footsteps.
So what are
they want to be bald like you too.
Yeah.
They want to lose their hair.
Lose their hair and have a tong tong.
No, seriously now, what are the three things that you can give out as tips? Like the best thing that they should have in their minds to be like
be
another
like
Joe
Coy.
Well, you know, here's the thing with Filipinos, we're so talented. I think out of all the ethnicities that are out there, like if you really look at Hollywood, Filipinos are in it. Like we are mainstream, and we are doing damage, and it's been like that for a year. We really have,
yeah.
and it's just fun to see like people dancing on TV that are Filipino, like the Jabberwockies, and then of course you got Chad Hugo over at Neptune,
Sheryl Burke,
you know, just all these people, and it's just so positive. So there's and of course myself, hopefully, doing stand up, and I just. If you want to pursue this, you know what I mean, in the entertainment, at least you know that you don't have to be a particular color to make it in Hollywood. You know what I mean? If you're talented and you pursue it, and if you got the skin, the toughness, mm-hmm. because it's tough out there, man. Mm-hmm. Hollywood's another world. It's not even part of America.
Definitely.
So, just stick with it and just have the passion and make sure it's in your heart. Because like I said, it took me 15 years. Mm-hmm. And there wasn't one year where I ever said I was going to quit. So that's one thing I can suggest.
Thank you, Jokoy. And here's to more laughs and more Jokoy on TV.
Hold on. I got one more announcement.
Okay,
just to let everybody know that's out there in the U.S., I am on tour with Russell Peters right now.
Wow, I'm gonna watch that.
Yeah, it's a huge tour, and we're hitting every city out there across the nation and across the country.
Love it.
So, mga kanation, abangan nyo si Jokoy.